boys and girls. Today is the second class of Java programming, possibly the third virtual class and second class of Java programming. I repeat again, let me recapitulate what has been done. I taught you three statements, boys and girls. The first one is an assignment statement. Second one is system.out.println statement, which will display the output on your monitor. That's a default output device. And the remark statement, right? And do your simplest program, which is there in your textbook, page number 65, question number 20. Page number 65, question number 20. What do they say? Write a program to determine the length of the wood strip which you require to frame a photograph whose length is 32 meters and whose breadth would be of 21 meters respectively. I repeat again, the question was, there is a photograph, you have to frame it. To frame the photograph, what would be the wooden strip or the bead which you require? The length of the photograph is how much? 32 centimeters and the breadth of this is 21 centimeters. How many lengths are there in a photograph? Two length and two breadth. So what is your perimeter is? Perimeter would be 2 into L is 2 lengths and 2 into B is 2B. 2 length and 2 breadth. In other words, 2 into L plus B is the formula. They have told you what is the L is. They have also told you what is the B is. Now that I am going to do the problem. Before we start writing the program, the thought process should go like this, boys and girls. What is the thought process is? We have to calculate the perimeter. To calculate the perimeter, this is the formula. 2 is a number which is a constant. You should have the length and you should have the breadth. In the question itself, they told you length is equal to 32 centimeters and the breadth would be 21 centimeters. Right? Now I am going to write the program. So tiny program, boys and girls, but you need to know what all the steps involved in them. Should I? Yeah. What are you up to? What you intend to do? It's a remark statement which finishes in only one line. I am writing a program to compute perimeter of a frame. Photo frame is there, whose perimeter I would like to compute. That is what we are, our intention is all about. Right? As you all know, anything and everything you do it, it should be in the form of a class. So, let me give the class name as whenever we name it, it's a two word. Deliberately I am giving this. One word also you can give photo or frame. Or you can give perimeter. Deliberately I want to teach you this. The two words are there. Between the words there should not be a space. It's not a rule. It's a general practice. What the general practice is? The first letter of the word should be always in uppercase. In uppercase. Class, photo, frame. Right? So what you have to do is, the moment I write a class, you should have pair of braces. Pair of braces. I repeat again, this is the class name. Inside the class, there are two components. You should have a data members and member functions. In other words, the variables and the methods. Methods or function is one thing. I am writing here a method called as a public method, which will not return anything. Public void main. I repeat again, this is the method. Again, the method has to be enclosed within pair of braces. You have a class called as photo frame. Inside this class, you have a method called as a main method, which is a public function. You go calculate and give the output and come out. This is what the method name is called. What is the method name is? Main. As you all know, they are given in the question itself. What is the length is equal to? 32. Boys and girls, please note, you are not supposed to give any units, centimeters, meters, kilograms, grams, rupees, dollar, pound, nothing. No measurements should be given, no units should be given. What are the length value is equal to? L is equal to what? 32. What does it mean? Semicolon. You are not supposed to give semicolon because this is the method. This is the class. Your class and the method, you are not supposed to give the semicolon. Inside this method, this is an assignment statement. I assign length is equal to 32 centimeters. Similarly, breadth is equal to how much? 21 centimeters. Right? It's given in the question itself. Length is equal to 32 centimeters and the breadth is equal to 21 centimeters. As you all know, how do we find the perimeter? Perimeter is equal to 2 length and 2 breadth. So I take the 2 common out, 2 into. So what do I do is, I give, why do I give a double? You can give integer also. Okay, double means where you can store the a precise value. Okay, double precision value. Even if you give integer, that's fine. So what do you mean by perimeter is? Peri is equal to. What the formula is? 2 into length plus breadth. You know what does it do? Computer will substitute the value of L, which is 32. Computer will substitute the value of B, 32 plus 21, which would be 53. 53 into 2 would be 106, whose answer will be stored in PERI. That I am doing verbally or mentally. That is not our work. That is what we use the computer for. Computer will calculate. If I give some thousands of value, lakhs of value, I will take my own time. Because it's a simple value, I add it, then I multiply it. If it's a big number, computer doesn't matter. It's a small number or a big number. It takes hardly a nanosecond. You guys know what is nanosecond is. A second is divided into 10 to the power of 9. Fraction of a second. Fraction of a second. So computer will substitute the value of length and breadth, which will add it up and multiply by 2, whose answer would be stored in peri. I repeat again, we have the length of a wooden strip, we have a breadth, we found out the perimeter. That perimeter, whatever is calculated, they are there in the RAM. From the RAM, you need to extract and display it on your monitor. To display it, what you do is, you use this statement. System.out.println. I repeat again, whenever you write system.out.println, S should be a capital letter. S should be a capital letter. Okay. What is the question is? They are asking you to find the length of the, as you all know, whenever I give backslash n, it will leave you a blank space. Anyway, I'll teach you next class. length of a wooden strip. Length of a wooden strip. I repeat again. I open the double quotation. I close it. Whatever I give, it will come as it is. Plus, what is this variable name is? As it is, you must give. Very. Look at here, boys and girls. They are given the length. They are given the breadth. You found out the perimeter and display the perimeter. If I display 106, you will not understand anything. No? So, length of a wooden strip means 106 cm square you require. Because centimeter, if you want, this also can be given. Centimeter also can be given. I repeat again. So, this has been given within double quotation mark. This has been given within double quotation mark. I told you in the previous class, whenever you open it, you close it. Whatever you give within double quotation mark will display as it is. Length of a wooden strip. Length of wooden strip, whatever the value is calculated, computer has calculated, 106 centimeters CMS. CMS within double quotation. And the program will come to an end. When you run the program, when you run the program on your monitor, you know what does it say? What is given within double quotation mark? Length of a wooden strip. What is the value of perimeter? Computer will calculate the perimeter. In this case, it will be 106. After this, what do you have? I am opening and closing. CMS means centimeters. CMS means centimeters. Is this clear? So, this is what the detail is all about. Right? So, this is the first program. Okay? Now, what I want to do, find is this. I wanted to do one more program. Okay? Let's do it. Should I do it? Yes. Boys and girls, after finishing this program, pause your video, copy down in your notebook. Your notebook should have this program. If you do not copy it, you add it. Please don't lazy out, because such type of programs will be coming in your forthcoming first term examination, second unit test, second term and the final term. By the time you will have normal classes, whatever the programs I do it in the virtual classes should be there in your notebook. Is this clear? Yeah. I will go to the next program. Next program, what is that called as? Assign any two value. The second program. WAP means write a program in Java. WAP is the shortest form of write a program in Java to compute addition sum, difference, product, quotient, and remainder. What I am going to do is, I am going to assign two values, value of A and value of B. Once if I give two values, add them, that becomes sum. Subtract B from A, that becomes difference. Find their product. Divide A by B, that would be your quotient. Divide A by B, if there are some remainders, use the remainder symbol, modulus symbol. Okay. This is addition, this is a difference, this is a product, this is a quotient, and this is a remainder. I am going to do 5 operations. Simple one. Assign any 2 value. Write a program to compute sum, difference, product, quotient, and remainder of 2 ASSGINED assigned numbers. Do you understand what I say? Assign any 2 numbers, find their sum, difference, product, quotient, and remainder. That's what I'm going to do. This is the second program of the day. Boys and girls, copy down this question. Let me do this. As usual, write the, after copying down this question, let's do the program. Whenever you write the program in your notebook, no matter what is the length of your program, in one page, one program should be there. Sir, it's a small program, there are 10 more lines are there, let free. Skip that page, go to the fresh page. Here is the program number 2. Program, what I want to do? Program to calculate, what I'm going to do? You're going to calculate sum, difference, that is addition, subtraction, then multiplication, this is called as product, P-U-R-O-D-U-C-T, then quotient, Q-O-T-I-E-N-T, quotient, and remainder. Right? This is the comment or remark statement of your program. Here I write a class. What is the class name you want to give? Calc. Calc means shortest form of calculator. Okay. As I told you, whenever you write a class, you should have a pair of braces. Okay. Inside the class, you should have 2 components. Data members and the member functions. Here I go. Public, static, void, main. I write a main method. Inside the main method, a class should be in a pair of braces. A method should be in a pair of braces. You have been told to assign any 2 values. Here I assign it. So, integer x is equal to 106. Integer y is equal to 43. Right. What do I do is, I write sum. X plus y. Integer difference. DIFF. SUM, DIFF means X minus Y. PRO, which is a product. X into Y. Followed by quotient. QU. Quotient means what happens is X slash Y. If you want, remainder. X modulus Y. I repeat again, boys and girls, X value is 106, Y value is 43. X and Y gets summed up, whose value will be in sum. Y value will be subtracted from X, whose difference will be there in DIFF. The value of X, 106, and value of Y is 43. Both gets multiplied, whose answer will be in PRO product. 106 will be divided by 43. Whatever may be the answer, I repeat again, 106. 43 when I divide it. What we have been doing, boys and girls, assign the value of x. as 106, Y as 43. Y as 43. What are we up to? We are adding the value of X and Y, which is done by your computer, whose sum will be stored in SUM. Y value gets subtracted from X, that gets stored in difference. The value of X and Y gets multiplied, whose value will be stored in PRO. X value, which is 106, Y value is 43. It gets divided, whose quotient, I repeat again, QUO is an integer value. What is an integer is? Number without decimal point. In this example, I'll tell you. What happens is 106 divided by 43. 43 twos are 86. Remainder is 20. Your mathematics teacher must have taught you, add one zero, put one decimal point, then 4 threes are 12, remainder is what? 4 fours are 6, 16, 16 plus 1 is 17. 1, again add 0, this is how it goes, right? But what happens is, because QUO is an integer, after the decimal point, the value gets truncated. Truncated means it will be chopped off. No matter whatever the value at the decimal point, they will not remain. Okay? So, let's not do this. So, this is called as quotient. That quotient will be there in QUO. I forgot to write one line. After this quotient, please write this. What is this? Integer. Integer. REM. Shortest form of remainder is equal to X mod Y. X mod Y. Mod means will give you the remainder. Okay, how it works, I'll let you know. Same thing, 106 gets divided by 43. 43 twos are 86. Remainder is 6 minus 6 is 0, 10 minus 8 is 2. So this one is called as quotient, this one is called as remainder, right? So what is the remainder is in this case? 20. 20 will be stored in REM, right? Comes down. Afterwards, what do you have? System.out.println then. What is some value is? As I told you, whatever you give, imagine this your monitor. This your monitor. If I give what did I give inside this double quotation mark? Within double quotation mark, what did I give? Sum. What the value is? SUM. SUM means SUM goes here. X plus Y. 106 plus 43, which will be 149. Afterwards comes down. Difference. Please note, had I not given this, if I do like this, for example, system.out.println, if I print only this DIFF, if I print only DIFF, what does it know? It shows only like this. (coughs) 63 will come. If I don't give within double quotation mark, it will come 63. You don't know what is the 63 is. That's the reason I give the message within double quotation. Difference. Right. Well, the next one is product. Computer will calculate PRO. It gets multiplied X into Y value, whose value will come here. Similarly, quotient will come here. Similarly, remainder will come here. How many outputs are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The first output is sum, second output is difference, third one is product, fourth one is quotient, and the fifth one is reminder. Boys and girls, this is the second program. Pause this video. I repeat again, for the third time in this class. Every program I do it in the virtual class. You must copy down in your notebook. Is this clear? You must copy down. By all means, you have to have. Your notebook will be checked. You know why I ask me to do it? So that you will have a practice of the program. Right? In one page, write one program. There are some blank lines will be there, skip it. See to that, in one page, only one program. Please practice. Such type of programs will come in your term examinations. Second term, third term, unit test. Unit test is over yours, but still. So you have to have, whatever the program I do in the following class, you should have in your notebook. Okay, today we have done two programs, boys and girls. Copy down, right? We will meet you in the next class. Till such time, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.